Multi-word verbs, general. A lexical verb may combine with a particle to form a multi-word verb, which behaves as a single unit of meaning. The participle may be an adverb or a preposition. For example, this calls for a celebration. Calls is the verb, for is the particle. Calls for means demands or requires. They've been turned down once already. Turned down means refused. Did mom and dad get away all right? Get away means leave or depart. I think I am going to drop off soon. Drop off means fall asleep. Some multi-word verbs have two particles. For example, he never looks down on her for what she is doing. Looks down on means disrespect, considers less worthy. He never looks down on her for what she is doing. I don't see why I should have to put up with that. Put up with means accept or tolerate. The particle is linked closely to the lexical verb and cannot be separated and fronted in the way it can in other structures. For example, off she run. Verb run plus adverb off. Non-fronted version. She ran off. Off ran she. Mom and dad got away all right. You cannot say, away got mom and dad all right. Multi-word verb get away means leave or depart. For Jill, I bought a necklace. Verb buy plus prepositional phrase for Jill. Non-fronted version. I bought a necklace for Jill. This calls for a celebration. You cannot say for a celebration this calls. Multi-word verb call for plus object a celebration. Calls for is equal to demand. The most frequent verbs and the particles they combine with to form multi-word verbs. Verb come, example particles into, off, out, up. Make, verb, example particles make for, make out, make up. Come, come into, come off, come out, come up. Get away, get at, get on. Pick, pick on, pick out, pick up. Give, given, give off, give up. Pull, pull over, pull through, pull up. go, going to, go off, go on. Put, put across, put forward, put out. Hold, hold against, hold on, hold to. Run into, run over, run up. Keep on, keep up, keep to. Set, set, set off, set out, set up. Knock, knock about, knock down, knock over. Take, take back, take off, take to. Let, let off, let out, let up. Turn, turn over, turn round, turn up. Look, look after, look into, look over. Work, work on, work out, work up. Multi-word verbs fall into three main classes, which are described in subsequent sections. Particles. The most common particles which combine with lexical verbs to form multi-word verbs are shown here, along with the section of verbs. Verb and verb, verbs plus particles they combine with. The most common particles in the verbs they combine with to form multi-word verbs. Particle about. Example verbs plus particle. Go, hang, knock, miss. Go about, hang about, knock about, miss about. Off, come off, go off, get off, take off. Ahead, forge ahead, go ahead, keep ahead, move ahead. On, come on, get on, go on, put on. Around, come around, get around, go around, knock around. Out, break out, come out, go out, put out. At, come at, get at. Look at, play at. Over, come over, get over, go over, turn over. Back, come back, get back, go back, tab, take back. Through, come through, get through, go through, run through. Down, break down, come down, go down, put down. To, come to, get on to, go back to, keep to. For, care for, go for, look for, stand for. Together, get together, go together, pull together, put together. In, come in, get in, go in, take in. Up, come up, open up, pick up, take up. Into, break into, get into, go into, run into. With, deal with, do away with, go with, put up with. Other particles include about, across, after, against, along, apart, aside, astray, away, by, for, forward, forwards, from, onto, under, upon. For example, she also come across as being stupid as well. Come across means appeared. She also came across as being stupid as well. Come across, came across means appeared. The fridge has fallen apart. Fallen apart means broken into pieces. A day didn't pass by when I didn't know what was going on. Multi-word verbs are written as separate words, not as a single word or with hyphens. For example, I think I am going to drop off soon. Not, I think I am going to drop off soon. You cannot write drop off all together. Not, I am going to drop off soon. You cannot put even a hyphen between drop and off. Phrasal verbs. Phrasal verbs consist of a lexical verb and a particle. Phrasal verbs may be intransitive or transitive. In the case of transitive phrasal verbs, the position of the object may vary. For example, you are not going to sort out your problems in a month. Sort out means solve. To a small child reaching for a drink at table. Careful, darling, don't knock that over. Knock it over means make it fall. A number of phrasal verbs are intransitive. They do not require an object. The radio alarm went off at the same time as usual. Went off means rang. I waited till the noise of the train died away, then walked home. Died away means became inaudible. Many verbs may be used both transitively and intransitively. There may be a difference in meaning between the transitive use and the intransitive use. For example, oh, better get back to reality now, I suppose. Intransitive, return. He wouldn't be able to stand losing Sony now. He had to get her back. Transitive, regain her or repossess her. I've got to set off at 5 o'clock. Intransitive, begin a journey. As soon as he moves, he is going to set the alarm off. Transitive, causes it to ring. Transitive phrasal verbs. Many phrasal verbs can be used with a direct object. The most frequent include blow up, break down, bring up, carry on, check out, close down, drink up, drop off, eat up, fill up, find out, finish off, give away, give up, hand in, hand out, hold up, leave out, look up, make up, phone up, put off, put on, ring up, rub out, save up, shut down, sort out, take back, take over, take up, tell off, throw away, try on, turn down, wake up, work out, write down. In most cases, the particle may come before or after the direct object, if the object is not a personal pronoun. For example, in Kent, burglars blew up a fireworks factory after trying to break in using oxyacetylene cutting equipment. Or burglars blew a fireworks factory up. Blew up means made it explode. We decided to put the meeting off for a couple of weeks. Or we decided to put off the meeting for a couple of weeks. Put off means postpone. As usual, it will be left to me to sort everything out. Sort out means organize. But don't throw away that fur coat yet. Throw away means dispose of. When the direct object is a personal pronoun, the pronoun always comes before the particle. For example, I've got a nice home. Yes, but I've got to almost give it away. You cannot say, but I've got to almost give away it. Give it away means take no money for it. Leave me out. What do you mean, leave you out? I don't want to go. You cannot say leave out me. Leave out means don't include. They couldn't wake her up. You cannot say they couldn't wake up her. If a pronoun object is coordinated with a full noun phrase or another pronoun, the objects may occur before or after the particle. For example, the noise woke me and my wife up. The noise woke up me and my wife. He didn't phone her or me up. Or he didn't phone up her or me. The OED, the Oxford Dictionary of English. I'll have to look up that word and its derivation in the OED. Or I'll have to look that word and its derivation up in the OED. Longer objects tend to come after the particle. Yesterday we were just finishing off looking at the structure and the land use of city and town. You cannot say yesterday we were just finishing looking at the structure and the land use of city and town of. Intransitive phrasal verbs. Intransitive phrasal verbs consist of a verb and a particle without an object. Frequent phrasal verbs which are used intransitively include break down, go off, run away, carry on, hang on, set off, drop off, join in, wake up, eat out, move in, move out, get back, get ring off. For example, it was a disastrous day because the coach broke down. broke down is equal to stopped working. He buys all his own food and he very rarely eats out. Eats out means eats at a restaurant. Hang on, let me write all this down. Hang on is equal to wait. We have to set off at the crack of dawn. That's gonna be fun. Set off means leave or start the journey. Prepositional verbs. Prepositional verbs consist of a verb and a preposition which are closely syntactically linked with each other. As with other multi-word verbs, fronting off the prepositional complement is not normally possible. I don't approve of his views on war and military things. You cannot say of his views on war and military things. I don't approve. Prepositional phrases follow different rules from phrasal verbs. The direct object must follow the preposition even if it is a pronoun. For example, I couldn't sell my car, I just couldn't do without it. You cannot say, I just couldn't do it without. Couldn't do without means need or have to. Frequent prepositional verbs include approve of, cope with, get over, break into, deal with, go into, call on, depend on, lead to, care for, do without, listen to, check into, get into, look after, come across, get on, look at, come upon, get off, look for. Common prepositions and some verbs which combine with them to form prepositional verbs. Preposition, across. Verb, come. Come across, cut across, run across, stumble across. After, ask after, inquire after, look after, take after. At, get at, glance at, laugh at, look at. For, ask for, care for, go for, live for. Into, break into, bump into, delve into, launch into. Off, become off, consist of, despair of, hair off. Off, feed off, get off, give off, go off. On, bit on, depend on, lean on. To, amount to, belong to, keep to, object to, with, agree with, break with, deal with, go with. For example, because lots of people break into cars, does that make it right? You cannot say because lots of people break cars into, does that make it right? Break into means enter by using force. You said you'd already come across that sort of stuff in the library. Come across means found. He says it's the pills that's doing it. But I can't do without them, he says. can't do without them is equal to must have. I managed to look after everybody for a day and a half. Look after means take care of. Some prepositional verbs allow an adverb or discourse marker to be used between the verb and the preposition. It depends entirely on what's going on at the time. I agree, I think, with most of his reasons. Verbs in this category include agree with, check into, keep to, apologize for, consist of, laugh at, approve of, cope with, lead to, ask for, deal with, lean on, belong to, depend on, live for, bet on, disagree with, look at, break with, glance at, look for, care for, go with, object to. Some prepositional verbs take a direct object after the verb as well as an object of the preposition. These include associate with, deprive of, remind of, bombard with, protect from, rob of, confine to, provide with, thank for. You don't bombard them with new stuff. Local white rulers enforced racial segregation by Jim Crow laws to deprive black people of civil rights. Just remind me of your surname again. Phrasal prepositional verbs. Phrasal prepositional verbs consist of an adverb, particle and a preposition. Common phrasal preposition verbs include catch up on, get along with, look out for, catch up with, get on with, look up to, come up against, listen out for, put up with, do away with, look forward to, watch out for, face up to, look down on, get away with, look in on. These verbs normally occur in informal contexts. For example, I'll catch up with you in a minute. Catch up with means reach or join. Let her get on with it. Get on with, continue doing. I'm looking forward to the weekend. Looking forward to means anticipating with pleasure. You have to watch out for the things coming along behind that you can't see. A small number of such verbs also take a direct object after the verb as well as an object of the preposition. Include fix up with, let in on, put up to, fob off with, put down to, take out on. For example, she is going to try and fix me up with a bit of part-time work. Fix me up with means arrange for me. Do you put that down to luck or judgment? Put down to means think the think the cause or reason is. He was just taking his frustration out on me, shouting at me and stuff. Taking out on me means causing me to suffer.